Hi everybody, my name is Penny and today you are joining me for Bunny's Bedtime Stories. Today I'm going to be reading The Sleeping Beauty, also known as Briar Rose. The Sleeping Beauty. A long time ago there was a king and a queen who said every day, "Ah, if only we had a child," but they never had one. But it happened that once when the queen was bathing, a frog crept out of the water onto the land and said to her, "Your wish shall be fulfilled. Before 1 year has gone by, you shall have a daughter." What the frog had said came true, and the queen had a little girl who was so pretty that the king could not contain himself for joy, and ordered a great feast. He invited not only his kindred friends and acquaintances, but also the wise women, in order that they might be kind and well disposed towards the child. There were 13 of them in this kingdom, but as he only had 12 golden plates for them to eat out of, he thought one of them had to be left at home. The feast was held with all manner of splendor, and when it came to the end for the wise women to bestow their magic gifts upon the baby, one gave virtue, another beauty, the third riches, and so on with everything in the world that one can wish for. When 11 of them had made their promises, suddenly the 13th came in. She wished to avenge herself for not having been invited, and without greeting or even looking at anyone, she cried with a loud voice, "The king's daughter shall in her 15th year prick herself with a spindle and fall down dead." And without saying a word more, she turned around and left the room. They were all shocked, but the 12th, whose good wish still remained unspoken, came forward, and as she could not undo the evil sentence, but only soften it, she said, "It shall not be death, but a deep sleep of 100 years, into which the princess shall fall." The king, who wished to keep his dear child from the misfortune, gave orders that every spindle in the whole kingdom should be burned. Meanwhile, the gifts of the wise women came true for the young girl, who was so beautiful, modest, good-natured, and wise that everyone who saw her was bound to love her. It happened that on the day that she turned 15 years old, the king and queen were not at home, and the maiden was left in the palace quite alone. So she went around into all sorts of places, looked into rooms and bedchambers just as she liked, and at last came to an old tower. She climbed up the narrow, winding staircase and reached a little door. A rusty key was in the lock, and when she turned it, the door sprang open. And there, in a little room, sat an old woman with a spindle, busily spinning her flax.
"Good day, old dame," said the king's daughter. "What are you doing there?"
"I'm spinning," said the old woman, and nodded her head.
"What sort of thing is that rattles around so merrily?" said the girl,
and she took the spindle and wanted to spin too. But scarcely had she touched the spindle when the magic decree was fulfilled, and she pricked her finger with it. And in that very moment, when she felt the prick, she fell down upon the bed that stood there, and lay in a deep sleep. And this sleep extended over the whole palace. The king and queen, who had just come home and had entered the great hall, began to go to sleep, and all of the court too. The horses too went to sleep in their stable, and the dogs in the yard, the pigeons upon the roof, and the flies on the wall. Even the fire that was flaming on the hearth became quite still and slept. The roast meat left off frizzling, and the cook, who was just going to pull the hair of the kitchen boy because he had forgotten something, let him go and went to sleep. And the wind fell on the trees outside the castle, not a leaf moved again. But round about the castle there began to grow a hedge of thorns, which every year became higher, and at last grew close up round the castle and all over it, so that there was nothing of it to be seen, not even the flag upon the roof. But the story of the beautiful sleeping Briar Rose, for so the princess was named, went about the country, so that from time to time king's sons came and tried to get through the thorny hedge into the castle, but they found it impossible, for the thorns held fast together, as if they had hands, and the youth were caught in them, could not get loose again, and died a miserable death. After long, long years, a king's son came again to the country and heard an old man talking about the briar hedge, and that a castle was said to stand behind it in which a wonderfully beautiful princess named Briar Rose had been asleep for 100 years, and that the king and queen and the whole court were asleep likewise. He had heard, too, from his grandfather that many king's sons had already come and had tried to get through the thorny hedge, but they had remained sticking fast to it and had died a pitiful death. When the youth said, "I'm not afraid, I will go and see the beautiful Briar Rose," the good old man tried to dissuade him, but he did not listen to his words. But by this time,
The 100 years had just passed, and the day had come when Briar Rose was to awake again. When the king's son came near to the briar hedge, it was nothing but large and beautiful flowers, which parted from each other of their own accord and let him pass unhurt. Then they closed again behind him like a hedge. In the courtyard he saw the horses and the spotted hounds lying asleep. On the roof sat the pigeons with their heads under their wings, and when he entered the house, the flies were asleep upon the wall. The cook in the kitchen was still holding out his hand to seize the boy, and the maid was sitting by the black hen which she was going to pluck. He went on farther, and in the great hall he saw the whole of the court lying asleep, and up by the throne lay the king and queen. Then he went on still farther, and it was so quiet that a breath could be heard, and at last he came to the tower and opened the door into the little room where Briar Rose was sleeping. There she lay, so beautiful that he could not turn his eyes away, and he stooped down and gave her a kiss. But as soon as he kissed her, Briar Rose opened her eyes and awoke, and looked at him quite sweetly. Then they went down together, and the king awoke, and the queen, and the whole court, and looked at each other in great astonishment. And the horses in the courtyard stood up and shook themselves, the hounds jumped up and wagged their tails, the pigeons on the roof pulled out their heads from under their wings, looked around and flew into the open country. The flies on the walls crept again, the fire in the kitchen burned up and flickered and cooked the meat, the roast began to turn and frizzle again, and the cook gave the boy such a box on the ear that he screamed, and the maid plucked the fowl ready for the spit. And then the marriage of the king's son with Briar Rose was celebrated with all splendour, and they lived contented to the end of their days. The end. Wow, that one practically ended with, and then they lived happily ever after, right? That was a really sweet story too, though. Last week's one was really sweet, and this one has been really lovely. Like, I'm kind of surprised by both of those. I'm used to the originals of these Grimm fairy tales being, well, grim, right? But once again, that was something, and then everyone was happy. I suppose a lot of princes did die trying to get through the thorns. And the moral is, don't snub wise women, because you will live out your punishment, because it really did, the whole thing happened, like it was 100 years, and the only reason that the young prince got in and met Briar Rose was because the time was up. Like, there wasn't a magic kiss that he had to fight his way towards, he just walked in. Good timing, I guess. If you've liked this video, please leave a comment down in the comment section and a thumbs up, because it really helps my channel. If you have a story you would like to see me read, please leave a comment down in the comment section, or if someone else has left a recommendation for a story that you agree with, leave a thumbs up to their comment so that I am more likely to see it. From the bottom of my little black heart, thank you for joining me down here on the floor for Bunny's Bedtime Stories. I'll see you all next week, or sooner. Bye! I'm just going to do that. I'm going to cut out that last little awkward bit. Don't need that last little awkward bit. That last little awkward bit just doesn't even need to be in the video at all. Maybe I'll put it after the credits, who knows?